for our learning target for today. I can understand the concept of photography and identify their purpose in taking good photos. For our art attack, let's talk about it. Concepts of photography, samples, photography challenge. Without light, there will be no photographs. This is why the basic concepts of photography refer to light. The concepts of photography make up your image's exposure or how light or dark your photos are. It is underexposed when it is too dark but overexposed when it is too bright. That's why, let us study the concepts of photography to help us capture better images and improve our photography skill. Aperture. Aperture refers to the opening in your lens that allows light to enter the camera. This opening is formed by aperture blades. The aperture controls the amount of light entering the lens. Points to note, the larger the aperture, for example, the smaller the F number. The larger the bokeh, the smaller the aperture, for example, the larger the F number. The larger the area in focus, depth of field. When the aperture is widened, the F number decreases. The in-focus area of the image decreases, and the bokeh gets more prominent or larger. Conversely, when the aperture is narrowed, the F number increases, the in-focus image area increases, and the bokeh becomes less obvious. Depth of field. The size of this opening affects the depth of field, which is the area of the image that appears in focus. The area outside this, the out-of-focus area, is blurred in a way that looks different from motion blur or camera shake. This quality of blurring is what we know as bokeh. Note, larger opening equals shallower depth of field equals stronger bokeh, while smaller opening equals larger depth of field equals less obvious bokeh. The bokeh also gets more prominent the closer the focusing distance. The range of focus, how much of the image is in focus, is known as the depth of field. When this range is small, it is known as shallow depth of field. Shutter speed. Shutter speed helps you control the movement of the subject in your photos. Points to note, a faster shutter speed freezes the subject in motion. A slower shutter speed creates a motion blur effect from the movement of the subject. You can adjust the amount of light by opening, closing the shutter. Shutter speed. It gives you the option to freeze the moving subject or allow a creative blur to show that it was moving. ISO sensitivity. In a low light environment, we can increase the shutter speed by turning up the ISO speed. Within normal ISO speed range, the lower the ISO speed, the higher the image quality. Increasing the ISO speed allows the camera to set a faster shutter speed. Noise occurs at higher ISO speeds. The higher the ISO speed, the more noise it generates. There are cameras with noise reduction features around, but most photographers will still try their best to keep the ISO speed to a setting that does enough to prevent blurring from camera shake. When moving from a bright environment to a dark one, remember to turn up the ISO speed. Otherwise, there will be a risk of camera shake. If you think you may forget, you can leave the camera in ISO auto mode. This is a convenient feature that automatically adjusts the ISO speed on the camera so that the shutter speed setting will be fast enough to prevent camera shake. To put it simply, ISO speed is the image sensor's capability to sense light, reflected as a numerical value. It is said that exposure makes or breaks a picture, but ISO speed is also a major factor in determining exposure. Be guided by these diagrams. Remember, photography is all about light. To let the camera see what you wish, you have tools controlling how much light reaches the camera sensor. The aperture and shutter speed controls. With too little light, your photo will be too dark. With too much light, it will be too bright. In both cases, some details will be lost. You use aperture and shutter speed to achieve the proper exposure, while taking into account some important side effects you should be aware about. The photography basics are fundamental for anyone who is beginning to work in photography, regardless of your interests, gear, or goals. Having a solid foundation of the main concepts of photography is key to capturing better images and improving your photography. Let's have our photography challenge. Take pictures at home by applying the concepts of aperture and shutter speed. Share and upload your work in the assignment part of this learning package. Assess your output using the self-assessment rubrics.